Good morning. Please stand for the prayer, the pledge, and the Holy Cross, man. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. O Jesus, through the Immaculate Heart of Mary, I offer you my prayers, works, joys, and sufferings of this day. For all the intentions of your Sacred Heart, in union with the holy sacrifice of the Master of the world, for the salvation of souls, the reparation of sins, and the reunion of all Christians, and in particular for the intentions of the Holy Father this month. Amen. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Father Moreau, pray for us. Saint Andre, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now for the Holy Cross Man. The Holy Cross Man is a fine gentleman who lives by faith. Devoted to his soul's welfare, he reflects often on God. His daily actions are sanctified by prayer, the practice of virtue, and manly piety. Since sanctity is his goal, he has deep devotion to our Lord, to Our Lady, and to Saint Joseph, patron of the school. The Holy Cross Man is studious. He regards learning as a duty, intellectual perfection as an honor. He knows that his school is his training ground where he has molded himself into a useful man. The Holy Cross Man is loyal to God and country. Devotion to his school and his teachers is demonstrated by his cooperation, zeal, and spirit. He is a friend of all because he is a member of the mystical body of Christ. In a word, he is a man of faith and honesty, of strength and character and self-mastery, of respect for the Christian family and lawful authority, of leadership in the pursuit of the true, the good, and the beautiful. That is the Holy Cross Man.
Academic game members, you meet today in room M206 at 2:45. That's academic.
Yo, 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 art club.
Meet today at in A203.
Nope.
A204.
Nope.
Five?
No.
Six?
No.
Seven?
Nine?
Yes.
Art club meets today in room A209.
Our freshman baseball team takes on John Curtis today on our own baseball field. Go out there and support our boys. The game does not have a time.
The freshman and eighth grade basketball teams will take on Brother Martin at Brother Martin today, starting at 5:30. Go support the eighth and freshman basketball team.
Tonight, our soccer team takes on who? Ben Franklin, that's right, at 7 p.m. on the field. Be there and support your Tiger.
Holy Cross is letting Holy Cross is having
Holy Cross Center Stage will be presenting the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee here in the Watson Family Theater. It's a very funny musical. You should buy your ticket Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Sure.
Our bowling team will take on Pope John Paul at Bowling USA at 3 p.m. tomorrow. That's going to be great matchup, Tigers versus Pope John Paul in bowling. Show your support.
Thursday, the 8th grade pizza party and social will take place 12:05 to 1:25 p.m.
Under the Oaks.
Under
the Oaks.
The Oaks!
Friday, we'll have a mass celebrating the Feast of Our Lady of Lourdes. Bring your tithes. That's Friday.
Goodbye, Holy Cross. Hope you have a great Wednesday.
Going on, Tigers. About a year ago, we did this thing where we would review some cars and trucks on the announcements, right? And, you know, I thought to myself, why don't we bring it back? You know, we got some nice trucks on campus, beautiful Civics, you know, Honda Civics. They're great. Plenty of them. So, thought about it. Going to review them on the announcements. And, of course, a little friendly competition. Going to have the students vote who has the better truck, you know? So, all you got to do is go to this Instagram page. There's going to be a little Google form to sign up. @holy_cross_trucks to sign up. You can vote on there whenever we have it. But sign up your truck, sign up your rig, sign up your car. It's going to be fun.
All right, Tigers, big game tonight. Wednesday, quarterfinals, Ben Franklin out on the north. We want to see everyone out there. Look, if you got a truck, maybe you can pull it up. Get all the boys in the back of the truck. We want to make it loud. We want to have everybody here. Kickoff is at 7 p.m. tonight. Tell your mama and them, everybody, bring them all out, and we're going to ring the bell tonight. Go Tigers!
What's up?
Tigers, I'm fired up. We're going to take no prisoners as we beat the Rummel Raiders. Go Tigers!
Today for the Rummel basketball game, I'm really excited for the sweep coming up soon. Only thing that I'm disappointed about is Kuvion didn't want to bring the grill out today for the game.
I'm here with Denny Trosclair. He just loves watching the basketball team play, you know?
Oh, yeah, man, I'm really excited to be out here, you know? Tigers versus Raiders, I got Tigers all the way. I got my boy Dallas out here supporting too, you know? HTOD, baby.
So we played Rummel again. We beat him the first time.
Just like football. We beat him in football, too.
Yeah, I mean.
So we're going to beat him again. Like, we're just
history
going.
Repeats itself, bro.
Hit it. Big game coming up. Couple games. We got a soccer playoffs going. We got state wrestling coming up. We got basketball coming up very soon. You got to be there, be loud, and support your Tigers. Go Tigers, baby.
At the basketball game tonight, I was very upset to not see that Cooper Kuvion was not grilling. I did not, in fact, get a burger before the game. His truck broke down on the way here. We had to come tow him out.
You ready to grill?
Where's the grill?
Grill will be there.
What's up? How you talk?
Oh,
it's a dub, just like football.
Big dubs.
Hey, COD.
We are. H-C, we are H-C. Anna, hey, goodbye.
Baseball is considered to be America's pastime. However, for the first half of the 20th century, its gates remained closed to African Americans. And while the sport enjoyed success with men like Ruth, Cobbs, Williams, and DiMaggio dominating the landscape, it wouldn't be until Jackie Robinson broke down the color barrier in 1947 that it truly became America's sport. Robinson was born in Georgia in 1919. His brother Mac was an athlete who participated in the 1936 Berlin Olympics and won a gold medal. Robinson would follow in his brother's footsteps. He would be a four-sport athlete at UCLA, the school's first. But baseball was always Robinson's passion. During World War II, Robinson was arrested and discharged from the Army for failing to move to the back of a segregated bus. Robinson would eventually, though, find employment in the Negro Baseball Leagues with the Kansas City Monarchs. Shortly after that, Brooklyn Dodgers general manager Branch Rickey selected Robinson from a pool of African Americans to become part of the Dodgers organization. He didn't have to be the best one, Rickey said, but he did have to be the right one. Rickey knew Robinson would face untold amounts of discrimination. After a year in the minor leagues where Robinson withstood death threats and a constant barrage of hate, he made the majors, debuting on April 15, 1947. Robinson would go on to win Rookie of the Year that year and transform the lowly Dodgers into a perennial World Series team. They appeared in six World Series in his 10-year career. Robinson, though, was booed, cursed at, threatened, and thrown at by opposing pitchers. He had death threats come through the mail daily. Yet still, he pushed on. In his 10-year career, he won the Major League Baseball MVP in 1949. And more importantly, he saw the arrival of more and more African-American players each year. Following retirement, Robinson worked with the NAACP, as well as Martin Luther King Jr. during the Civil Rights Movement. He opened up a bank in Harlem to help out African-Americans get business loans. Robinson was selected to the Major League Baseball Hall of Fame in 1962. He died a decade later. On April 15th of each season, Major League Baseball recognizes Robinson. His number, 42, is the only jersey to be retired by all franchises in Major League Baseball. Baseball was at the forefront of American culture, and for the first time, it was an African-American, Jackie Robinson, taking the lead and stealing home and pushing down barriers of segregation. Through Robinson, generations were inspired to stand up and break down those barriers in all walks of life.